And what is up, everybody? It is your boy Fry. Thank you once again for tuning in. Today we're gonna be looking at a Lil Uzi Vert style auto-tune effect. You know what I mean? We're just gonna be really breaking down the auto-tune. I'll be breaking down just some techniques and tips using auto-tune 8.1. And yeah, pretty much just more so for rap, slightly sing song, not so much full-on singing. So if you enjoy the sound, stick around. We are using the Lil Uzi Vert Eternal vocal effect, or recording template, as I like to call it. So yeah, here are the settings for those that are in a rush. Feel free to take a listen, and you know, we'll be breaking down each kind of knob that is important in my opinion. So let's get it. Yeah, remix, yeah. Hit that lick. Ride around with Shotty, Michael's Marchie Dorky. Yeah, 40 pounds. Blowing pounds. Yeah, stars around my neck, stay clean like some laundry. Yeah, rockstar life. Take a flight, yeah. Take a bath, yeah. Clean like white, yeah. Serving white, diamond white, Look like Mr. Frosty smoking on that broccoli. So there you go, that's just a piece of what we have. So yeah, if you rap in a similar style, definitely obviously you have for Lil Uzi Vert settings, then these would be the go-to settings. So I'll just, you know, basically break down, as I said, just a few things that are important. Now, in my opinion, Auto-Tune 8.1 is the best Auto-Tune that you will find. You know, growing up, you know, we used to use Auto-Tune Evo.
Hear what it sounds like.
Auto-Tune 5, Auto-Tune 4 even, you know, those were back, you know, when you had such a large latency with the Auto-Tune. But, you know, this one is just boss of that. You know what I mean? If you grew up in that era, this one is just it, because the layout is still the same. Everything is still the same, but you have a few additions that really help you, you know what I mean, get a great result. So the first thing I'll start off with is just that there's a low latency mode. With this enabled, you can actually record with Auto-Tune without this setting. So if you look right there in the top left corner, you'll see there that the latency is 2.31 milliseconds. What that means is the time that the Auto-Tune is required to actually compute what's going on. Now, if you turn that off, the latency becomes so large that there's a, you know, you can hear this kind of gap between when you speak and when you hear your own voice through the headphones. So yeah, that's just, to me, it's just awesome, because, you know, you're able to actually record with the Auto-Tune on. And, you know, it's really important for me, you know, if I'm recording someone or something like that, to actually have them record the Auto-Tune if they want the Auto-Tune effect, because, you know, things might sound a bit strange after you've, you know, recorded and then add Auto-Tune, you know, just like certain words might not sound the way you'd want them, you know what I mean? So it's really awesome to be able to emphasize what you'd like with Auto-Tune. I think Future is someone who's amazing at doing that. But yeah, let's kind of break down what we have. So we got the pitch correction control section, which to me is really where you're going to be working. These four knobs, you know, are going to save your life. Actually, these two right here. So the first thing, retune speed. For this kind of style, I would stick between about, let's say, 20 and then about 7. That's kind of the sweet spot if you really want to get that kind of slightly distorted auto-tune sound. Now I cannot remember where I was, 8. All right. And then humanize, basically what that means is, right there, adds realism to sustain notes at high retune speed. So basically, if you want to do like a long at the end of your verse, the auto-tune is kind of going to let go of that part and let it sound a bit more natural, because, you know, for those that do R&B and stuff, you might want to, you know, slightly hide the fact that you're using auto-tune or not have it as emphasized. Now, this correction style as well does the same thing, and this is what makes this auto-tune so amazing. It's using the classic algorithm, which is the one that we all know and we've all heard on Lil Wayne's records and all of that. But if you want a more natural R&B style, definitely go for that flexi tune. This is almost going to kind of mask the fact that you're using auto-tune, and it's going to set in a bit later, so it's going to allow you to kind of be a bit more natural sounding. So yeah, create vibrato, I would kind of leave around. This is kind of a whole nother world, but for rap, I think you can get away with just utilizing these three knobs and then obviously using the low latency. Now, obviously, don't forget to, I don't know if I still have that on. Yes, I do. So this is a great plugin that's going to help you actually figure out what scale your song is in. So if we play this again, we can just see this trying to understand what the beat is sounding like, and then we can actually set our auto-tune according to what we see in the key estimation. So let's hit play again. Yeah, remix, yeah. Yeah, hit that lick. Yeah, ride around with Shotty, Michael's Marchie Dorky. Yeah, 40 pounds. Yeah, blowing pounds. Yeah, stars around my. So there you go. You know, this is such a smart software right here, Hornet Songkey MK2. So it's about like $15. So You know, $15 over, if you record 100 songs here, you're saving so much time, because having to record yourself and then pick through, you know, every single scale, right? You know, there's 12 options here. Over time, that can save you just tons of time, you know what I mean? And just get to recording. So yeah, I'm gonna keep this video short. Hope you learned something. Auto-Tune 8, you know, God mode right here. Pinnacle of recording. If you want the OG classic sound, I definitely recommend Auto-Tune 5. Maybe Future still uses it, I don't know, but you know, Seth used to use Auto-Tune 5 on Future. So RIP Seth, go out there and make some good music, you know what I mean? If you are interested in this sound right here, or all the vocal effects, all the settings I've used right here, feel free to check out the link in the description. You can purchase this FLP2 with all these settings and all that kind of thing. No vocals included, by the way, but yeah. I'll check you out next time. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Peace out.